Hey, it's Tom. Today's video, I want to give you 4 tips on how to be able to learn anything quicker. So tip number 1 is start first from the right principles. Every skill set, everything you want to develop, there are certain core foundational principles that once you understand about the particular area that you're looking to learn about, that connect up to everything else. So when you're learning anything particular, you want to become a better gardener, you want to become a better photographer, you want to be a more effective cyclist, you want to be able to lead meetings more effectively, you want to be able to run a company more effectively. There are certain core principles that when you've identified what they are, will have a huge impact. Now, I'll cover perhaps how to be able to identify what those principles are in another video. But for now, a quick tip or two in regards to that is find somebody who's already knowledgeable or an expert in the particular domain or area, the skill that you want to develop, and notice what, and you can obviously interview them and find out what they identify, what they would describe as the core principles, the things that are fundamental principles that show up time and again that are essential that every person should know. So, for example, in the photography space, if you're looking to become a better photographer or videographer, understanding about, in this case, aperture, ISO, and shutter speed are 3 key principles in this case and elements that you would need to understand in order to make sure that you have a basic knowledge level to be able to work with a camera effectively. There are many others, but those 3, every good photographer is going to know how to be able to use the right aperture, shutter speed, or modify the ISO in order to get the kind of look that they want. So when you're looking to learn something, focus on the principles first. What are the organizing principles, the principles that have the biggest impact? There are generally only a small number that you need to know, but once you understand those, they will allow you to be far more effective. Secondly, is get the sequence right. So when you're learning something, there is a particular sequence that if you learn it in the sequence in which you're, for example, acquiring the skills that connect directly back to the principles, you will be able to acquire it quicker. So if you're going again with photography, if somebody just gave you a camera and told you just point and click, and they focused all on composition and how to frame the picture, well, if you don't understand light and where light is coming from, and you don't understand things like shutter speed and ISO and the aperture, how much light hits the sensor, then you may have a great framed picture, you may have it framed right, but you're not going to be able to get a picture that's exposed right, that actually looks like a good photo. So when you're looking to learn something, a particular area, you're going to want to know what is the right sequence. And there are many different sequences that can get you to your outcome, but you're looking for one that's efficient and that actually produces the desired result. Again, how can you find out which sequence is going to work best for you? It depends on what the skill is, but if you can interview an expert, that will help. If you can't, what you can most certainly do is going on to Amazon and go and find 15 or 20 books in the area and do something. If you're into Paul Sheely and photo reading, or speed reading is another format, you can syntopically read, which you identify a whole bunch of books and you look for the broad patterns. What are the patterns that show up again and again in this topic? The core ideas, they will act as the organizing principles. And then you can look at how particular experts in that domain have organized the information. Some people may start off, for example, focusing on composition, even though I know a few photographers that start off on focusing on composition. Others will focus on lighting, reading the lighting. Others may start with the mechanics of the camera, but you can notice the particular patterns of how they've organized the information. That will give you an idea of the different sequencing that people have used to try and teach others to learn that skill. And then you can come up with your own pattern, or you can model if it is a dominant pattern that shows up, a way that people have organized information, you can follow that pattern too. And chances are you will get a good result. The third key principle or idea to get if you want to learn something quickly is make sure that you follow the right gradient. So right now here I am, I'm on a nice hill, okay? There's a bit of a gradient, there's a bit of a dip. When you are learning something, you don't want to choose a gradient that's so steep that it acts as a demotivator. If you find that you're learning a new language, for example, and there's too many things coming at you at once, and you find that it gets overwhelming, for most people, they find that acts as a demotivator and it actually puts the brakes on their learning. And in fact, they may get no reward from that experience, and so they just give up and stop because they go, it's too hard. So anytime you're learning a particular skill, you start with focusing on the principles. What are the organizing principles about how this particular skill is produced or achieved? What sequence do you need to learn the principles and maybe techniques or other information that's relevant to produce that particular outcome? And the third thing is to make sure that you've got the gradient right. You don't want a gradient that's so steep that it seems impossible, and you don't want something that's too weak or too easy, because there's going to be no challenge. So for you, you're going to choose a gradient depending on what skill level you're already at. If you already know quite a lot about the subject, then you can afford to have a sharper gradient. If you know nothing at all, to begin with, it may be just a gentle incline. Yeah, that you acquire new bits of information, and then once you've got that core foundation of knowledge, you can increase the gradient. But by doing that and choosing a gradient that works best for you, you'll be able to acquire and absorb new information quicker and quicker. That's why if you're particularly knowledgeable in a particular subject, or you're an expert in a particular area, that you can pick up a book that's 300 pages long and you could read it in 10 or 15 minutes, because the vast majority of information in that book is something you already know. There may be only one or two new ideas. While somebody else who knows nothing about that subject or is a new novice at it, it may take them a week or two to get through that same text, because it's a steep gradient and they don't understand and haven't taken the time to figure out what are the organizing principles around the skill and the sequence in which they acquire that knowledge in order for them to be able to find that the gradient is completely doable, and that they're able to acquire that information quickly. And finally, the fourth tip to be able to learn anything quickly is practice. And that means outputting. A lot of time when people pick up a book or they try and acquire a new skill, they think that just because they can regurgitate and repeat something that they know it. But a skill literally is behaviorally demonstrable. So that means you need to practice and do the activities that are involved in doing that skill. So if it was swimming, it would mean getting into the pool and actually practicing the stroke. If it was photography, it would be going out and shooting different scenes. It may be landscapes, it may be portraits, depending on the type of photography you're into. And applying your knowledge to the context, the actual situation in which you're looking to demonstrate those skills. If it's in a work context, if it's running meetings, that you take on and you run more meetings, but you do it in a way where if you really want to be good, you go into the specific situation and you set a particular goal and output that you want to produce. So if it was in a meeting, you say that you want the meeting to go really smoothly, that it's going to last no more than 25 minutes, and you're going to cover these three agenda items, etc. And you set some specific tangible outcomes, something that you can measure, so that when you get to the 25 minute mark, to use that as an arbitrary example, that you're able to go, have I done this in 25 minutes? Did I cover the three items involved? And whatever other criteria you have used to be able to assess your own performance. And by doing that and reflecting on what went well, what didn't go well, what you could improve, what you would do differently, that self-reflective process, which really is tip number 5, if you will, to learn anything quickly, that will allow you to be able to quickly make dramatic improvements in your performance, regardless of the area. This is how all the best learners, this is some of the common meta-strategy, if you will, that's used, there's components here, used by everybody who's really good at learning anything quickly and easily. So I hope you found that useful. If you've got questions or is anything else you'd like me to cover, submit it below in the question box. Please go ahead, subscribe to my videos here on YouTube. And in the meantime, also go check out www.nlptimes.com for more cool resources. Thanks for watching.